Alrighty, welcome to a modern video here on channelfireball.com. I'm playing a sweet Esper Atroxa deck. This deck's gotten pretty popular in modern, and it looked like a really fun deck. Plus, I've played a fair amount with various reanimator decks, and this is a pretty cool take on it. So, what this deck's trying to do is put an Atroxa or Gristlebrand into play, discard it with Tainted Indulgence, Faithful Mending, or mill it with Phalagi Archaeologist, and then hit a Goryeo's Vengeance to bring it back. You then can ephemerate it, because both of those cards, Gristlebrand and Atroxa, have a pretty good shot at finding you an ephemerate. If you get to ephemerate it, then you get to keep it forever with Goryeo's Vengeance, while also ephemerate working with Grief and Solitude, so you get that kind of like 1-2 punch, some Forces of Negation here, because that card's really busted, and some Surveil lands, Shadowy Backstreet, Meticulous Archive, Hedge Maze, like these lands, and Undercity Sewers. These lands do go a really long way. Sometimes they're just Spike and Atrox or Gristlebrand and just be off to the races. So I'm going to take a look at this deck today, and as always, this video is brought to you by Ultimate Guard, sponsor of Team CFB. Let's get to round one, playing a league, and I'm going to keep this hand on the draw. I don't have either a Goryeo's Vengeance or one of the creatures yet, but I have a Surveil land to try to dump it in the graveyard, and then Phalagi Archaeologist and Tainted Indulgence. Oh, blue-green Merfolk. All right, Sanute Scout revealing a Merfolk Trickster and keeping it on top. Fair enough. Let's go ahead and lead on Undercity Sewers here. Oh, there's Grief. Never mind. I think I'm just going to double Grief here. It's actually going to end up being triple Grief in a second here. So let's go Plains, Evoke, Pitching, Indulgence. I mean, it's kind of why this deck is sweet. So hopefully we don't get forced, but one of the cool things about this is I get to put the Evoke trigger on the stack and the Grief trigger. So first I resolve the Grief trigger. I mean, this is classic scam nonsense. And let's take... I'm definitely going to take Lord of Atlantis and Hexcatcher, I think. Oh, or no, maybe Lord and Master of the Pearl Trident. I mean, I guess they're just going to play the Hexcatcher, but they don't have Island Walk. And then I get to take Cenote Scout or Trickster. All right, I'll take Lord of Atlantis for now, and then I'll ephemerate the Grief. And get it again here. And... Master of the Pearl Trident. Yeah, because I think I want to take the Island Walk ones here. And then the Evoke trigger doesn't do anything. Well, I mean, this worked out pretty nicely. I will not block this turn, but soon I will be blocking. If I can, I suppose. And my plan turn two here is going to be just get an island and play the Scout, or the Archaeologist, rather. Oh, they didn't play there. Okay. I'm curious what their plan is here. They didn't play their Lord to give +1/+1. All right, I'm gonna try to ephemerate the Grief. They can Merfolk Trickster it, but that's not actually gonna do anything. It'll just come back and still Grief them. So I think they missed a point of damage because I think they're still gonna just play their Lord now, but you know, we'll take it. Ephemerate Grief is pretty good. It's even better than Undying Evil in that you get a third card out of the deal. All right, so here comes the, I assume, basic island. And let's play their Vidalian Hexcatcher. I think that's what it's called. I wasn't really paying attention to the title. I haven't actually put that card in any deck so far. All right, Vidalian Hexcatcher, yeah. All right, they could sack a Merfolk to make me pay one, but that's not going to do anything because I don't even have to pay a single mana here. Pretty nice. And then Grief you, and yeah, let's just take Merfolk Trickster, I think. All right, and then Force Negation is not a great draw. I think I just get Island here and then play Phalagi Archaeologist. And let's see. Oh yeah, I'll take a Tainted Indulgence for sure. Pass the turn, and they can attack with the Scout. I'll block with the Grief. They can attack with the Hexcatcher. I'll block with the, well, I guess I'll block with the Grief on that too. scout, revealing Tide Shaper so they can make one of my lands into an island next turn. That doesn't seem like Tide Shaper is going to be as good as just trying to dig for a lord. Oh, they're running it. Okay. Take my turn. Oh, there's a Gristlebrand. Oh, let's just get Undercity Sewers. I'll put Grief in my graveyard here. I don't think I'm looking for that. I guess they do get to make my Undercity Sewers into just a basic island here. Although I think Tide Shaper is an addition to its types. Okay. Hopefully this isn't a lord. Oh, yeah. Oh, no, it is an island. Okay, so it's just a straight-up island. I guess they can attack with one of the scouts now. No, still just waiting on that Lord of Atlantis. Ooh, a black source. I'll take that. Shadowy Backstreet putting, ooh, an Atroxa into my graveyard. That's pretty nice. And I still do need to find a Goryeo's Vengeance, but now Goryeo's Vengeance right away works. Though, I think with Tainted Indulgence, Gristlebrand, I was going to have something to go in the graveyard anyway. It'd be funny if this Force Negation hit, but they don't play very many spells in their deck, so I'm not holding my breath here. Had I not drawn Grief on turn one, I would have gotten just completely demolished this game. But Grief on turn one was just absurd. I mean, they kind of should start attacking. My 3-2 is keeping three different 3-3s back here. All right, I guess I'll accept that. Let's go Tainted Indulgence now. If they want to sack three Merfolk to counter it, they can. And sack the Gristlebrand, play Meticulous Archive, and now I just am looking for Goryeo's Vengeance. So Solitude? Yeah, I'll put Solitude on top, though. Hardcasting a Solitude next turn sounds pretty good. Kill the Hexcatcher. They can't counter it because it's a creature spell. Oh, end of turn. The Trickster. Yeah, they can tap the Grief and attack for a lot. I guess I take 12 here down to 5. It's kind of a lot of damage. Need that Solitude. The Solitude will be pretty nice, but I am going to take a lot of damage here. I think I block the Hexcatcher here. And I need them to not have another play. Oh. This could be problematic. I guess if it's a spell, I can pitch Atroxa, though I kind of want to cast Atroxa in a couple turns here. The Hedge Maze providing green mana is pretty nice. This looks like another Tide Shaper, actually. Oh, Spreading Seas. They have no cards. Yeah, I'll have to let them. I don't think Force Negation is good. I would like to cast this Atroxa. That's one of the ways I can actually come back here. Draw. Play Hedge Maze. Bin Polluted Delta and pass the turn. So I'm at 5. I'm really going to be at 8 after Solitude gains me life. I think what I'm going to do here is I think I'm going to Solitude the Tide Shaper. Oh no. Oh no. I'm probably going to have to Solitude this. Yeah. That was the draw. Okay. Well, I'm not dead, luckily, so let's cast Solitude. At least I don't think I am. And Solitude. I got to hit Lord of Atlantis. I'm at 5. I go up to 8. Yeah, actually, no, this looks okay because I can block the Hexcatcher, block the Tide Shaper, and then just chump. I go to 2 because they can't just sacrifice this without a target. And then now I'm at 2 facing down those. I don't think I need Faithful Mending. I think I have a swamp. Yeah, okay. I have one swamp in my deck that I can get. It doesn't cost me life. And I assume I just slam Atroxa here. It'd be nice to pick up another pitch elemental. And I think I leave the Solitude back. Let's see. I get to get Instant creature land sorcery. So sorcery is going to be prismatic ending. Creature, I guess I could just take the archaeologist. And land doesn't matter. And then instant, I'll take ephemerate. Okay. So I die to a lord no matter what. If they trickster me, I die to that no matter what. If they bounce Atroxa. Yeah, anything that gets Atroxa off the board. So that kind of makes me want to just hit with Solitude because I think I die to all the same things anyway. And they have one turn to answer Atroxa or draw a lord. And after this turn, things get completely out of reach for them. Okay. If they play a Spreading Seeds this turn, I'm definitely Force of Negationing it. I don't want them drawing into one of their outs, and Force of Negation doesn't do anything anyway. Okay, if you got it, you got it. Lords, yes, no, maybe so. I mean, that was a nice game. That was a nice game one. Oh, Supreme Verdict is excellent here. Prismatic Ending, Solitude. Subtlety, I don't like that much. Definitely don't like Force of Negation. I think Thoughtseize is kind of bad, but what I'm thinking of with Thoughtseize is they are going to side in a couple counter spells. So I might want a little bit of an answer to that. Maybe I can take out a Phalagi Archaeologist or two since I'm putting in all the things. I have these Griefs still, I suppose. I don't know. We'll see. I'm on the draw here, and this time I don't think Millions of Atroxes is good. And I don't have any of my discard outlets. I do have Gordial's Vengeance and Atroxa, so I'm two-thirds of the way there, but not the last one. All right, we'll mulligan. Well, this is a turn one Grief. I'm definitely going to keep. I think I'll just Grief Pitching Grief and then Faithful Mending Atroxa. That seems like a plan to me. And I guess I get Hallowed Fountain for the Marsh Flats here. Turn one Relic. It actually doesn't interact with the Grief combo here. It's kind of funny. Tainted Indulgence. All right, well, let's get Hallowed Fountain, pay two life. Grief, I'll evoke Grief. That's fine. And make them discard first. They mulligan to six, and I kind of hope they have some spells in hand. Yeah, so let's take Lord, ephemerate this, take the Hexcatcher, and they're left with Mutavault, Waterlogged Grove. I mean, I'm on one land, so it's not like I'm going anywhere all that quickly. Didn't Relic my Marsh Flats? Tisk Tisk. Oh, they drew a Merfolk, which is a shame because I can ephemerate here, but there's nothing to get. Their last card's a Waterlogged Grove, so I guess. Do I want an ephemerate in my graveyard? No, because then I don't get to attack with Grief for the turn, and I don't really like that. So let's pass on that. Land would be nice. Not great. I'm just going to chill here. I'm not beating them by attacking, so trading 3 for 2 isn't good, and they can even fire up the Mutavault, so I'd rather just wait here. They drew a Lord. That was a nice draw. A nice set of draws. Merfolk into Lord, huh? Well, I guess I'm kind of dead here. I mean, if I draw a land here, then I can get something going. Oh, Prismatic Ending. Oh, that's actually not too bad. Oh, wait. This is an island. I got a little ambitious there. All right, pass the turn. They get to keep Relic in play. I don't think they have a strong reason to use the Relic. And it does protect them against my combo nonsense. Incarnation. Gotcha. So I get hit for 6 down to 8 here. No, don't attack the Lord. All right. And then if I draw a white source, I can actually prismatic ending the Lord of Atlantis, which is great. All right. A little painful, but let's go ahead and get Godless Shrine, pay the life, prismatic ending Lord of Atlantis. And then now I'm at 5, but I can block Tide Shaper and take 2 going to 3. And then Faithful Mending buys me kind of a turn. So I actually don't mind this at all. I mean, I'm not in good shape, but if they miss on creatures, then things could be all right. They are going to want to crack the relic at some point here because they run the risk. Yeah, now it makes sense. They run the risk of not being able to actually close out the game. So their position's gotten bad enough, they're cracking relic, which I like because that gives me some good outs here next turn. And if they draw another Lord, I'm just dead right away. Otherwise, things aren't going too badly. Like if they hit land here, trade off Tide Shaper, go to 3. Merfolk creature spells. That's not good. This is another Tide Shaper. That's actually pretty good here. It does mean, though, that they're not likely to attack with their Tide Shaper. Because they're currently kind of mana screwing me here. All right. Land? Oh. Actually, kind of want a Solitude so I can cast Faithful Mending here. So let's go Solitude, pitch Faithful Mending. I think I want to free the Godless Shrine. And unfortunately, no Ephemerate. And then now I can go Tainted Indulgence. I don't need to gain the life yet. Draw 2. Discard Atroxa and pass the turn. So I didn't draw a land off that. But as long as I don't die this turn, if I can then Faithful Mending next turn, and then the turn after that, maybe cast Supreme Verdict. They didn't have a Lord last turn. They didn't crack Waterlogged Grove either. So I'm not sure exactly what their plan is here. Oh, Animated Mutavault. Oh, this is excellent. This is like really great news. Because now I get to trade for Mutavault here and set up Supreme Verdict. And I don't really care about that Tide Shaper. I feel like this attack means they didn't draw anything. All right, let's go Faithful Mending. Gain 2 life, draw 2 cards, discard 2. I'm discarding Grief and I think Faithful Mending. Then I'll play a Polluted Delta and end of turn, I can crack the Delta and get a Surveil land. And right now, if I get a white Surveil land, oh, this is Merfolk Trickster? They didn't Merfolk Trickster and tap my Grief and just attack me? Well, that's wild. All right. I mean, I'm pretty dead because now I'm going to 1 here, but so I can't crack this Delta, but strange. All right. Let's draw. I don't really think I have too much that can help me here. Thoughtseize. Yeah. All right. Well, if they have relics in, I don't really have a way to stop that. But I just have to kind of go off through the relic. I guess I have prismatic endings. Yeah, this looks all right. I guess I'm down to run it. All right, I would like to play first. All right, I'm going to keep this hand. This hand just needs to find a discard outlet or to spike on one of the Surveil lands. I think that that's good enough to keep. Also, with Ephemerate in hand, if I find one of the pitch elementals, then I also have a pretty good draw. So I feel like keeping this, getting to Surveil and going from there gives me a pretty good shot. Hopefully they don't play a turn on relic. And hopefully I find, oh, they are gonna play turn on relic. Oh, Vile. I don't know if that's better or worse for me, honestly. Let's see what I find. I think I'm gonna get Shadowy Backstreet. Oh, put Atrox into the graveyard. Oh, yeah. And then, do I just fire this off now? I've got to. It just hits for so much. Let's get a Hallowed Fountain here. Pay the 2 life. And this means they can't put like a Merfolk and like a Vidalian Hexcatcher into play. And I can discard to hand size here. Though I didn't find... I was really hoping to find another Gorgeous Vengeance. It's okay. We got Grief, Tainted Indulgence, I guess Supreme Verdict, and I think I can take a Hedge Maze. And then I can exile Gristlebrand to cast Grief and Grief you. Okay. Lord of Atlantis, Stern Scolding, Tidebinder, Hexcatcher. Tidebinder's pretty annoying. All right, let's just take the Tidebinder and then send with Atroxa. And then I have Supreme Verdict soon here, and I have a lot of life, so let's just take the Tidebinder and force them to overcommit with Merfolk if that's what they want to do. And then draw. Oh, Prismatic Ending is really good, because I'm going to go... Now I'll just play this land, the Flooded Strand, and then Prismatic Ending on the Aether Vial here. And they can't really Hexcatcher me. And then in response to the Hexcatcher, I'm actually going to Tainted Indulgence here. I assume that they're dropping Hexcatcher. And then I can set up a nice Wrath. I like it. And then here, I think I just get a basic island. Seems fine. Tainted Indulgence. Discard Atroxa here, and now I have Goryeo's Vengeance. I also have a Thoughtseize, which maybe I want to fire off at some point here. Their hand is 3 cards. It's Lord of Atlantis and Unknowns. I guess I would like to Supreme Verdict here. The one downside of playing the untapped land this turn is I don't get to Supreme Verdict. Oh, are we not playing Lord of Atlantis? All right, I'm at 21, so I've got a bit of time here. Let's just go Hedge Maze. I'll put Gorgeous Vengeance on top because I feel like it getting countered is a big part of what goes on here. Actually, let's Thoughtseize here. What am I thinking? And then I have Faithful Mending as well. Okay, so they have Endurance. Yep, I'll take the Endurance. Well, I'm glad I kept Thoughtseize in. Did they really not Endurance me in response? Yeah, that is odd. Because then my Atroxa would be gone. I guess I have more ways to discard here, but... Okay, they didn't want the Aether Vial. That makes a lot of sense. Now they kind of have to play this Lord. I mean, I don't know. It depends what they've drawn, I suppose. Keeping up Stern Scolding doesn't seem like the biggest priority. Here, let's cast Faithful Mending here, see if they sack a Merfolk. They do not. All right, let's discard. I guess I discard Supreme Verdict and Thoughtseize here. And take some damage, and they have 3 cards in hand. Oh, I see. And they're not playing the Lord. There's the Stern Scolding for the Grief. Well, let's just cast Goryeo's Vengeance on this Atroxa, and I assume win the game from here. Like, what are they going to do? They're going to sack 2 things so we can pay 2? That's not going to work. I get an Atroxa to play, I'll find an untapped land, and I'll Ephemerate it, and at that point, I mean, I should be able to bury them in cards. I could even find multiple Griefs and just, like, start throwing Griefs at them, even though they Stern Scolding them. All right, 1-0 here. Let's get to the next round. All right, time for round 2. I would like to play first, and, battling against Gigant of the Wellspring. This is a nice hand. All right. So this hand does need to find a land, but I get to go Delta. Let's see. I need to get either white-black or blue-black. Or sorry, blue white or white black. I mean, it's pretty close. I'm just hoping whichever one I pick, I draw the other one for Tainted Indulgence. I guess I'll go white black. I think that's reasonable. In case I discard to hand size eventually, I don't know. I'll play Evoke Grief with Gristlebrand. Look at my opponent's hand. Ancient Stirrings, the One Ring, Grazer, and a bunch of Traverses. Okay, well, I'll take the One Ring, and then Ephemerate, and then take Grazer. And then next turn, I'll go ahead and take Ancient Stirrings, or whatever to get off Ancient Stirrings, because I assume that they're probably going to cast Traverse on turn one. Okay, there goes Ancient Stirrings, sure. Or I guess they're going to take Stirrings. And the thing is, if they get a land, that's fine. I don't know. I guess there's an argument for taking Ancient Stirrings and Grazer, leaving the One Ring. They got a Commercial District, sure. All right. Untap, Ephemerate. I guess them getting a land is a reason to take the ring, sure. I'll take a Traverse. Oh, they do another Ancient Stirrings, whatever. I'll take another Ancient Stirrings then. And then I don't actually want to grief them here. First of all, it doesn't do anything. Second, I need all the cards in my hand, because now if I draw a blue source, I can go Indulgence, discard Atroxa, and so on and so forth. Oh, they drew Explore. Okay. They draw a land off it. Or they had Commercial District, I guess. So their hand right now is like two Traverses and unknown with three card types. They really want to hit a land. Yeah, they did. All right. That's no good. All right. Well, it was a strong start, but we're in a bit of trouble now. Bit of a pickle. If I can draw a blue, I think I'll still be all right. Okay, so now they get to go get any creature or land. Traverse is officially on. I'm going to get some Eldrazi here. Vesuva for Eldrazi Temple. All right. And then Traverse. Well, if they get an Eldrazi here, I can grief it at least. They got another Vesuva. Okay. Blue, blue, blue. Oh, that's a blue. All right. So I'm going to actually do this now. I'm going to get Watery Grave, pay two life, cast Tainted Indulgence. The reason I'm doing it now is if I draw another black card, well, if I drew another black card, I could have griefed again, but this looks okay. Okay, they get to do something. Perhaps. Another Traverse, okay. Are they going to get a Thought Knot Seer? Well, that'd be pretty annoying, because I've also, despite really needing a land the last two turns, now I was hoping to hit a black card for grief, or even a white card for Solitude would be decent. But here we are. They got another Eldrazi Temple. How many Eldrazi Temples do you need? They didn't want to put Gigantha in hand either. All right. Just play the Island. Goryeo's Vengeance, the Atroxa, leaving Ephemerate mana or Thoughtseize mana. Didn't hit an Ephemerate. Okay. Well, let's get instant creature and land, huh? Well, it's actually kind of awkward. So creature, I guess I have to grief them this turn. Attack for 10. I mean, they're pretty close to dying. That's kind of nice, I guess. So if I'm going to grief them, I guess I could take Goryeo's Vengeance and Grief and pitch. Yeah, I'll take Goryeo's Vengeance, Grief, and I have some. I can already get Surveil Lands, so I suppose I'll take a Plains. And then I'll pitch. Well, actually, at that point, Goryeo's Vengeance doesn't do anything. I think I'll take the Faithful Mending. Then I'll just pitch Grief to Grief, and then Faithful Mending, I can pitch to Solitude if I really need to. All right, let's grief you. All right, I just thought it had to be some just massive Eldrazi. Attack for 10. I mean, they were going to get to do that next turn. And then pass the turn. Atroxa goes away, sadly. And next turn, I'm still surprised they didn't put Gigantha in. What? They drew an Eldrazi? Okay. I guess that's one way to do it. An Emrakul, the Promised End. Oh, this isn't that bad, actually. So this has protection from instants, but I'm going to get to Solitude it. They get to gain a bunch of life. That part is annoying. So they're going to go to 17, but I guess what they can do here is they can crack Marsh Flats to get a Surveil land and put something bad on top, or mill something good if there's something good. Or they're just going to play the Undercity Sewers, sure. And they're going to leave that on top. And then I'm going to take my second turn. I'll draw Hallowed Fountain. Right, they're not going to attack, obviously. All right, well. And then hit. And then end of turn, I get to Surveil with the Marsh Flats, I guess. And they're on nothing except they can get Gigantha, and they can't even cast it this turn. I can't believe they just drew Emrakul, the Promised End. All right, well, that's fine. And then they could probably... Oh, Echoing Deeps. There's no good lands to copy, I suppose. Okay, they got their forest, sure. Let's crack Marsh Flats and get the last, or one of the last two Surveil lands. Get the Shadowy Backstreet. Marsh Flats can't get Hedge Maze, and... This deck doesn't have white, green, or black, green, I don't think. It shouldn't. Yeah, just have the Hedge Maze. Yeah, in that case, I think I'm just going to Graveyard the Atroxa. Now Goryeo's Vengeance is alive. Prismatic Ending is pretty bad, so let's just send with the Grief. And... They can play Gigantha. The Prismatic Ending was just kind of a brick of a draw. Sad. But they've gone through two Emrakul, the Promised Ends. They've gone through a lot of Traverses. I could see this working out all right. Like, they need to draw something. Obviously, there's a lot they can draw that can, like, bust the game wide open. But I have a lot that I can draw to do that, too. So I don't feel too bad about this. If I start seeing these Eldrazi Temples tap for... Two colorless can only be used on Eldrazi, then I'll get a little more worried. They have 12 mana if they really want. Oh, no, they did draw an Eldrazi. Okay. Oh, all is dust? Sure, that's whatever. All right. Meticulous Archive, deliver it to me. Graveyard. Boom. Okay, Faithful Mending. Let's start the chain here. Discard Prismatic Ending and Hallowed Fountain is fine. Let's play Phalagi Archaeologist. See if I can hit that Goryeo's. I milled three spells, okay. And I'm gonna wait on playing this land, because I could flashback Faithful Mending if I played the land, but then I'd have to discard the Solitude plus one of the two cards I drew. Let's just wait. I'm wondering off the top. It's so funny, because I'm like seeing four cards a turn with my like filter lands and Faithful Mendings, and they're on one card per turn, but, you know, it's been a good one. They should probably copy, yeah, Surveil land. Okay, I mean, if I draw one of my Goryeo's, it's still pretty good. Oh, Prismatic Ending, and I don't have the fourth color. That's so funny. All right, well, let's flashback Faithful Mending then. There's Thoughtseize and Tainted Indulgence. I guess I can discard Plains. And I think Prismatic Ending, I'm just pretty far away from getting that fourth color. Though Thoughtseize doesn't do anything either. I can't cast it this turn, and they're just going to... No, I'll just discard the Thoughtseize. Actually, I haven't played a land. Why don't I just discard Thoughtseize, Prismatic Ending, then just cast Tainted Indulgence? And then I didn't even have to discard. Oh, that's the hedge maze. Yeah, I can wait a turn on the Falaji Archaeologist, I suppose. All right, they lose one life. They get to draw two more here. And I assume they're going to play something kind of good, but who knows. Vesuva copying Surveil Land. Oh, I milled my hedge maze. I just noticed that. Okay, I guess I didn't really need to wait on this Delta, but it's fine. Grapple with the Past. Oh, now they get to Emrakul me. I have the Solitude again, which is funny. But no white card here. All right, I guess I'll sack the Delta. I don't have actually that much to get with it. Oh, I couldn't even play the Falaji Archaeologist. All right. Well, they can Emrakul me. I don't know what it's going to do. I guess they get to cast Falaji Archaeologist and kind of waste it, and then they can cast Solitude. Cue me drawing Goryeo's Vengeance this turn. This matchup didn't feel too bad. It felt like there was a lot I could draw that would be awesome. Though it does make me want to keep the like Grief Ephemerate One-Lander a little bit less in a future game, because they, I mean, post-board's going to get a little different, but at least in game one, they can't really stop me from doing my thing. And I don't need to disrupt them because their game plan is going to be good even if I make them discard a few cards. Well, here I hit the Goryeo's Vengeance. Unfortunately, it's not going to help me very much. Like, they can Goryeo's Vengeance the Atroxa. I mean, they should take it, I think, because they can Goryeo's Vengeance it. Any card that they get off it that is bad for me, they just get to cast. And they can then get the Atroxa out of my graveyard as well. All right. So now they can pitch cast Solitude. Kill the Archaeologist, attack the other one into... Oh, should have killed the O3 and then attacked into the Emrakul. All right. And pass the turn. Oh, Gristlebrand? Gristlebrand. All right. Let's cast Gristlebrand. Hopefully that's good enough. I mean, could be worse. All right, so now they take some damage. So they take 2 to 8. I mean, they're going to draw, but it means Gristlebrand's lethal. Maybe they don't. I mean, obviously, there's like a million cards they could have here that'd be really bad for me. But we'll see. Binding of the Titans. Okay. Each player mills 3. And then what? And then are they casting another Eldrazi? Are they casting Jagantha? Well, all right. I mean, I feel like I'm in pretty good shape now. Because they can't attack with Eldrazi, the Emrakul. Let's draw. I mean, I don't have that many cards left, but let's pay 7 life to draw. Yeah, I mean, this actually kills them. Because I can go Goryeo's Vengeance on Atroxa. What a wild game. I guess, is there any reason not to Thoughtseize first? I can't really think of one. Their hand is nothing. Okay. Goryeo's Vengeance, Atroxa. And then now they just die on upkeep to the One Ring. I mean, I guess I'll put Goryeo's Vengeance and Force of Negation in my... Oh, no. I want Force of Negation in my hand. And I don't even want the rest of these cards. They don't do anything for me. All right. That was a game. We got game one. I like Commandeer against the One Ring is great. Solitude, I think, and Subtlety. Subtlety-ing an Emrakul the Promised End isn't very good. No, it's actually really bad. Thoughtseize, I think, is fine. Grief's fine. I don't really want Supreme Verdict or Teferi that much. I guess of these cards, I guess I'd rather have another Force Negation, but... it's possible I want some Prismatic Endings against, like, them having Relic of Progenitus. Maybe... Though Force Negation's probably still better there. All right. I think this looks okay. Maybe Solitude... Altitude isn't that great. No, it's pretty good against Emrakul. All right. I'm good to go. Opponent is on the play here. And I'm going to hope to just have a fast hand here. All right. I'll keep this hand. This hand has everything I need. It has Vengeance, Gristlebrand, and a discard outlet. I just need to find a second land. But I'm on the draw, and I have Hedge Maze, so I feel pretty good about that. Force Negation is actually not that bad. Ooh, Ephemerate, I do not want. All right, well, let's see if I can find. If I have blue, black, or white mana, both work here. Ancient Stirrings. I kind of want to Force Negation that, but I don't think I will. The main reason I don't want to is I kind of want to save it for like a Relic of Progenitus. I'm a little more worried about that. They did hit Eldrazi Temple, which I can't counter. But I'll allow these Ancient Stirrings to occur. Also, if I don't draw a land here... Oh, they hit Forest. I don't mind that too much. Oh, into Grazer. Okay. They have three cards in hand. They're going to put the Eldrazi Temple, and they have two cards. If I don't hit a land here, I can just discard a Gristlebrand as well. Oh, Watery Grave. Perfect. All right. Pay the life. Pass the turn. I have Tainted Indulgence up, I have Force Negation up, and because I can now do this turn three, One Ring, yeah, let's go Tainted Indulgence, because if I draw a Commandeer, then we're talking. Discard Gristlebrand, Force of Negation, pitching Faithful Mending, and then we're going to Gristlebeezy here. Goryeo's Vengeance, the Gristlebrand, hopefully they don't have like Endurance as their last card. Or Surgical Extraction. Oh, they did have Endurance with a creature. Okay. That's fair. Still a 2-for-1 in my favor, but, you know, is what it is. Then go Hallowed Fountain tapped. And now I've got another Goryeo's Vengeance, and I have Archaeologist and Faithful Mending, so I get a lot of looks. All right, Vesuva on Temple. They have no cards in hand. I feel like we're doing just fine here. Okay, Phylogy Archaeologist leaving... Well, I guess it doesn't matter because I can't cast anything else this turn anyway. All right. Do I want a Tainted Indulgence? Oh, I milled a Gristlebrand, and yes, I do want a Tainted Indulgence. All right. Milling Gristlebrand was pretty nice. Now I get to go off next turn again unless they draw something here. They did not. All right. We're cruising here. Goryeo's Vengeance, my Gristlebrand? Yes, please. Pay 7 life. Smash and pay 7 more life here. Maybe more. I don't know. Let's draw 7. I think this is probably going to be sufficient. Okay, yeah, because now I can Ephemerate. And I don't need the mana for anything else, so I'll just play the Shadowy Backstreet. Sure, I'll keep Ephemerate on top and then discard. Million cards. All right. They can Verdant into a Commercial District. Wow. I mean, I have Force Negation and Commandeer up and Solitude up. So I can kind of stop any non-creature easily with Force or Commandeer. And creatures, I can at least Solitude. Could they even Eldrazi this turn? Let's see. Could they Emrakul? They have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. No, they can't even do that. All right. Land. Grief. Thoughtseize, Grief, Land, and Phylogy Archaeologist. Oh, one more also. Oh, and Atroxa. I'm discarding. Okay. And what are they going to do? What are they going to do? Nothing, I assume. Let's draw. Ephemerate the Phylogy Archaeologist. And get back an Ephemerate. Wow, going off. And then here, I guess I'll play the Swamp and then go Goryeo's Vengeance on the Atroxa. Okay, they didn't seem to have anything. Let's get Solitude, Land, Faithful Mending. It's funny, this deck doesn't hit that many different types for Atroxa. And I guess I'll Solitude the Arboreal Grazer. I think pitching that to deal 7 damage is worth it. especially since I'm about to have to discard a bunch anyway, because I'm going to ephemerate the Atroxa and put in Solitude, Faithful Mending, Marsh Flats. I could have taken a Thoughtseize too, but I would just be discarding it anyway. I think I didn't even play a land that turn. All right. I think we're going to be fine here. And boom, a nice little 2-0 start. Let's get one more here, shall we? All right, time for round three. I am on the play. And this hand... ooh, so I could turn one Ephemerate Grief. You can't really mulligan a hand that's turn one Ephemerate Grief. The question is, do I want to keep Goriel's Vengeance in my hand or Atroxa? I get to only keep one of the two. My inclination is to keep Goriel's Vengeance because I have a lot of ways to mill and I just have the four Goriel's Vengeances. Like I have a bunch of Surveil lands and Phalagi Archaeologists and stuff. So I think that's what I'm going to do. Planes, pitch Atroxa to grief you, and then do the whole Ephemerate thing. And then hopefully their hand minus three cards gives me time to find a way to get a legend into the graveyard, at which point I should be in good shape. All right, my opponent did mulligan to six as well, which is going to make this even tougher for them. All right. Young Wolf, Court of Calling. All right, so definitely take Young Wolf and then Ephemerate it and take, I guess, Yawgmoth, because if they draw another Yawgmoth, I'd rather just take both Yawgmoths and leave them with a Cord. Blooming Marsh. All right. It's pretty gnarly. You get to come back for a third card on this. Grist and Cord. Well, I definitely take Grist. Swamp, pass the turn. I guess I could have Prismatic Ending the Grist now, but that Cord is pretty far away from doing something, especially if I Prismatic Ending the first creature they play. Okay. I like that fetch lands just now are ways to Surveil too, which is pretty cool. I'm not going to pitch cast Grief here. I could just draw a land and cast it. That would be fine. Verdant Catacombs. All right. Land would be actually pretty good here. Oh, Tainted Indulgence is pretty good too, I think. I think it's worth just casting it. Because if I draw a Surveil land, it's really good. Also, obviously, if I just peel a big creature, that's good too. They have three cards in hand. Forest Cord, Unknown. I guess I can discard Faithful Mending and just flash it back. Let's play this shadowy backstreet here. Any Atroxas? Oh, yeah. Oh, that's an Atroxa. All right. Hit you with Grief. And then next turn... I mean, next turn, if I draw a black card, I could even fire off the Grief first. Okay, they milled a Swamp. And unless they've drawn an Endurance, I feel like I'm in pretty good shape here. Haywire Mind, that does not matter. It enables their Cord, I suppose. Okay, let's just go Goriel's Vengeance on Atroxa. And hope to hit an Ephemerate here. Oh, that'll do it. Up a game here against Yawgmoth Arena. I mean, Celestial Purge is pretty good against the Yawg himself. Don't like Force Negation. Subtlety is also decent. I don't really like Supreme Verdict that much. The main problem I have with Supreme Verdict is... if they have Yawgmoth out and you Verdict, it's like they just draw a bunch of cards anyway. It doesn't really do anything. Prismatic Ending, I think, is okay. I have to take out a couple here. Maybe I just don't play the Subtleties. I don't know. Subtlety is good, but... cut one Prismatic Ending. Yeah, I think something like that. I'll leave a mix of Solitudes and Prismatic Endings. And then put in a bunch of... Celestial Purges that kill Grists and Yawgmoth. That's the plan. I mean, the plan really is to just grief them for three cards, just turn one Mind Twist you for three, and then that buys enough time that I could find otherwise. Well, speaking of which, so I do need to draw a black card here, but I think I'm going to keep this, because even if it's a turn two grief that's still pretty good. Oh, well, I guess I'm going to get my grief thought seized. That's fine. I've got solitude ephemerate instead. Ba-boom. And I have turn one hedge maze, so I get to set things up kind of nicely here. Okay. Oh, ephemerate got taken. Sure. Just cut the combo out completely. That makes sense too. Yeah. Can't keep a good ephemerate down. Well, let's just put Gristlebrand into my graveyard. Now if I... It's so filthy when you hit Surveil Land into just creature, like one of the big creatures, without setting it up in any way. Not that this deck even has a way to set it up. I could have kept it for a grief ephemerate, but I think I'd rather just start to get the combo going. Okay. Well, I'm definitely going to get a black-white land. I'll call the Shrine. I think I'm just going to grief here. Grief pitching the Thoughtseize. Let's see. Oh, hand is just Yawgmoth. I guess I'm not ephemerating. All right, grief's down. Let's just play Phalagi Archaeologist. And, oh, that's a Goryeo's Vengeance. I will select that one and put it into my hand. Now they have one turn to draw a graveyard hate card or a discard card or the game just ends. Anyone? I mean, I guess they could try to draw Bowmasters, but that's not even going to do it. Oh, they drew a Young Wolf. Okay, well, I respect the hustle, but I think this game is about to be donezo. All right, let's fire off this Goryeo's Vengeance on Gristlebrand. Mm-hmm. Pay 7 life, go to 10. Just need to find an untapped white source. All right, there we go. Hallowed Fountain, go to 8. Tech and Ephemerate. And I don't even think... Oh, actually, no, I'm going to pay 7 more life. I was going to not do that, so I guess I could have waited on the white, on which white source to play, but this works just fine, and I don't need to do any griefing because I know their hand. Discard Atroxa, grief, Gristlebrand, Atroxa. Marsh Flats, and I guess a Phalagi Archaeologist and another grief, sure. A million cards, but it doesn't really matter because I even have Solitude here. Like, I don't even think a Yogg play does it. I guess we'll find out. But if they play Yogg and then they sack a Young Wolf in response, I'll just Solitude the Yogg. And then that kind of leaves them stuck. And then next turn, with Gristlebrand here, I imagine I'll be able to find a Goryeo's Vengeance. I guess I should start by ephemerating the Phalagi Archaeologist. Tainted Indulgence and Faithful Mending, sure. And draw. And I got into one. What could punish me? Cord for an Orcish Bowmasters. I guess there's just no reason to lose to that, is there? I'll take my time. I probably win if I find a Goryeo's Vengeance, but I probably win if I don't, so let's just chill here. No reason to get greedy. Play Shadowy Backstreet. Sure, I'll put that in my graveyard. Just pass the turn. Like, I don't really want to lose to them courting for an Orcish Bowmasters. Okay, it doesn't appear that they have the Court of Calling anyway, but why tempt fate? It would be, you know, nothing but hubris if I was to pay 7 life there. Oh. This Yogg. Oh no, they did have the cord. Cord for 4. Okay. Not really sure what they can do with this. Phyrexian Metamorph, copy or Gristlebrand. Yogg. Okay. They're at three now. They've already played their land. Celestial Purge, the Yogg, I guess. I don't really think there's a real big reason to wait. And Solitude, Pitching, Faithful Mending. They get to gain some life here. But I think we're done. All right. 3-0. Let's go for one more, shall we? All right. So round 4, 3-0 on the play. I've had a lot of griefs here. Oh, I like this hand. I mean, it's on the low end of hands, but turn 1 Thoughtseize, turn 2 Archaeologist, Tainted Indulgence. Like having all that lined up seems pretty good. Let's just get Godless Shrine. Godless Shrine is going to be one of the first lands you want to get with this deck, just because it's got a lot of early black and white cards. All right, so playing against Tron. So Tron land, Sylvan Scrying, Karn. Yeah, I'll take the Sylvan Scrying, I suppose, because they only have 2 of the 3 Tron lands. Power Plant and Mine. So the lead on Mine. Okay, they didn't play a 1-drop. That's nice. Oh, Goryeo's Vengeance is really good. So let's go Flooded Strand. I think I just get Basic Island, honestly. And cast Flogy Archaeologist here. See if we can mill a Gristle or Atroxa. We didn't, but I think we just take the Tainted Indulgence here. But we should still be fast enough, because they can play an Urza's Power Plant here. And they didn't draw anything else to play, so all right, there's Solitude. Let's start with Tainted Indulgence, I suppose. Draw 2. Yeah, that's getting a little dicey. All right, let's play the Hedge Maze. Goryeo's Vengeance. I'll put that in my graveyard because I don't need another copy of that. Pass. All right, well, now if they've drawn the tower, which they're giving themselves the best chance to. Oh, now at least I'm lucky they didn't draw that a turn sooner, because now they can play Urza's Mine. They'll have a ton of mana next turn. And they're going to be able to Karn. Basically, I need to find it this turn so I can start getting some griefs going. There's Ephemerate. I guess Ephemerate on the Phalagi Archaeologist is good, though. Now, actually, I wish I had played a different land for mana purposes, but I guess this sees 3 cards, so I think that's better. Okay. And I could also draw a Thoughtseize off of it. Okay, let's go. Let's mill 3. I hit Atroxa. Okay, that's good. And here's where I mentioned having played the Hedge Maze instead of cracking for a Surveil land wasn't as good. I only had 1 untapped black to get funny. Because now when I Goryeo's Vengeance Atroxa, I can't cast Ephemerate or Thoughtseize. But I want to find Grief. All right, I found Grief, instant creature land, and sorcery. I want Force of Negation. And I want Marsh Flats. Yeah, that's fine. I guess I'm running out of fetchables, and I guess Thoughtseize, sure. And then here, I am going to want to Grief them. I think I pitched the Thoughtseize. All right, well, I didn't hit the Ephemerate anyway, so let's Grief you. All right, definitely take the Ulamog here, leaving Karn, which I can hit with Force of Negation, and Wyrmquill, which I can get with Solitude here. So I get to play Wyrmquill or Karn. They can't do both. They know I have Force of Negation in hand. Oathstone. Okay. I mean, that actually is not the end of the world, because if they Oathstone, that stops one of my Goryeo's Vengeances. I unfortunately had to surveil one into the graveyard earlier. But if they Oathstone to stop that, I still get to draw a bunch of cards. Oh, and they're not casting anything else. Well, that's great. That plays into what I have very nicely, because I don't have anything. I even get to Ephemerate the Archaeologist, though. Okay, they chose not to Oathstone that. All right, I milled Gristlebrand Atroxa, but I did not hit any spells to bring back. And now I guess I just cast Grief. I think that's fine. And then this ought to make them O-Stone at some point here. All right, Grief, take your Karn. Because I just don't care about the Wurmcoil, and I'd rather have Force Negation up for a different threat. And then pass. And I guess they don't have another Tron land? I don't. Or do they? I can't really tell. Yeah, they did. So they can leave up Wurmcoil plus O-Stone, I suppose. I think that's all right. And let's crack Marsh Flats as well. Get a Surveil land. Yeah, Meticulous Archive. All right, can I find another Goryeo's Vengeance? I think I can graveyard that. I feel like I have a lot of ways to spend my mana already. Oh, I do like Ephemerate. Okay, so I could flashback. My Delta doesn't have much left to get. I can still get something, but I guess I'll play it anyway. And then I'll hit with the Grief, because I guess they can't block it. Okay, and then pass the turn. I kind of wish now that I had countered the O-Stone. I don't think it was right to at the time, but given they didn't play the Karn and I drew a discard spell, kind of feels like that would have been better. It's actually not clear to me that they want to make the Wurmcoil indestructible. Or like pro O-Stone. Because of Solitude. That's funny. Do I want to Solitude that? I guess I don't need to. What I think I'm going to do, actually, is after they attack with the Wurmcoil, I think I'm going to block with the Phalagi Archaeologist and Ephemerate it. But let's crack this, because I only have one target left to get. So I want to make sure I don't end up without. All right, block. Ephemerate you. If they want to O-Stone now, they can O-Stone now. Then I'll play End of Turn Solitude on the Wurmcoil. And I'll have a Solitude in play, and I'll still have a Force Negation. And I'll have some cantrips to cast. All right, you get to pop the O-Stone. Top tower is what you want to do. All right, O-Stone is enabled. Ephemerate resolves. You have three cards in hand. One's a forest. They never had a chance to play it. They have anything else? Ooh. Sylvan Scrying. How much do I care if they get a land? They can't get anything too scary? Maybe not. I feel like it's still better to use my mana here. Urza's Saga? Sure. They already played their land because they had to play Sylvan Scrying. All right, let's cast Solitude. They just have a bunch of cards in their deck that I really need Force Negation for, and I don't have that many counters. So that's kind of where I'm thinking. Okay. I guess I'll start casting some Tainted Indulgences. Okay. I do want to hit a land drop, though. So let's cast another Tainted Indulgence. Look at these just draw twos. I don't know if Marsh Flats gets anything. I guess we'll find out. I think it doesn't, unless I have basic planes left. Oh, I actually think I have basic planes left. That's exciting. And if they draw an Eldrazi, I'm in a lot of trouble regardless. Finding another Force of Negation was kind of nice. Relic of Progenitus. I mean, it also cycles. Yeah, I got my basic planes. Yeah, let's just Force of Negation that. I feel like keeping my Goryeo's Vengeance alive is pretty good. One card left. Did they bait me? Oh, another Sylvan Scrying. I don't think that's a huge issue. Urza's Tower, yeah. Okay, now I get to cast Atroxa. I get to hit them down to 10. Green, black, one. And I still have Force Negation up. Instant creature, sorcery, land. So the land doesn't really matter. I do like Ephemerate. I guess I have to... Oh, they're done. They're done? They could just draw an Eldrazi, but okay. Commandeer? Yeah. Subtlety? I kind of like Force Negation more, but I guess these Prismatic Endings are mostly bad. I know that they can hit Relic of Progenitus. That's just such a weak play. Solitude is also like just okay. So maybe I just do this. Don't really want Teferi. I don't think I want Surgical Extraction. That's just not how these games play out. All right. I think I like where we're at. Let's battle some Tron here. And I'm on the draw. Like I said, I've had more than my fair share of grief ephemerates. But wouldn't mind more. I'm going to keep this hand for multiple reasons. One is I'm on the draw and have a Surveil land. And then a Phalagi Archaeologist and Tainted Indulgence. So a lot to play if I find a blue. I also already have the Atroxa and I have Ephemerate. But I also have Commandeer, which could be sweet, or Subtlety. So I have some moves to make, even if I end up in a spot where I'm stuck on one land for a turn or two. All right, my opponent mulled once and kept Urza's Tower. Relic of Progenitus. I don't know. Am I supposed to Commandeer that? I would be pitching like those two, and then I would get the Relic. I kind of want to save Commandeer for like Karn or One Ring. And they mulliganed. Oh, well, I'm really glad I didn't, because now that would have been a disaster. Now I'll have to win through those. That's okay. Okay, well, I drew my blue land. Actually, I'm going to put Ephemerate on top. I feel like now that I have my land lined up, Ephemerate Archaeologist is just a pretty good way to get a bunch of value here. They're probably going to be forced to crack this relic at some point. The Stone Brain. Sure. I mean, drawn all your hate pieces, but I guess I'm okay with all that. I don't know. We'll see what it does. And I guess Watery Grave? Yeah. Do I Tainted Indulgence here, or do I Archaeologist? I guess I Archaeologist in case I want to pitch Tainted Indulgence. It'll depend. Did I get a spell back? I didn't. All right, well, that's a beat. I milled two lands and an Atroxa. So what are they going to name with Stonebrain? I'm going to name Goryeo's Vengeance, I guess? I don't really know. I guess we'll find out. The thing is, they're already pretty protected against Goryeo's Vengeance, because they could name... Like, I'm not planning on discarding this Atroxa. This Atroxa is going to get cast. They could name Ephemerate. It seemed kind of unlikely they do that. They could name Atroxa? I mean, I guess we'll find out. Let's see. They activated the Stone Brain and they named Goryeo's Vengeance. Yeah, sure. I'm not saying they shouldn't have these cards in their sideboard or bring them in against me. I'm saying this is kind of the risk of all this. Like, yeah, they could still definitely win this game, but like, they've now played three cards to answer Goryeo's Vengeance, a card I haven't even drawn. Of course, my deck is built around it, and I have the setup. I have an Atrox in my graveyard and all that, but like, they already have Tormod's Crypt. That counters the first one. Relic kind of counters the second, because they need to leave mana up for it, but I don't know. It's annoying that they see the Commandeer, because that is an annoying card for them to know about, but I feel like we're doing all right here. Grief would be a pretty good draw. Another Archaeologist. I think I want to cast Tainted Indulgence because I would like to hit a land drop. Okay, I guess I won't. I'll discard a Gristlebrand because I'll just be casting Atroxa. And I'll send, and they didn't play a land last turn either, I just want to note. past the turn. I'm regretting keeping this ephemerate on top. And they're not even using the relic. I mean, I guess if they're just going to pop the relic, it doesn't matter. Chromatic Star, sure. Get a green. See if they hit their land a drop. If they didn't, they better crack that relic. It's kind of crazy not to. I don't even have Goryeo's Vengeance in my deck anymore. And then the One Ring is a card they can't really play. Not with a Commandeer in the grip here. Are they did they have a, another Urza's Tower into Expedition map? I don't think I want to Commandeer that. I want to Commandeer a Karn or something like that. Oh, that was the downside of... I see. All right. That's the downside of discarding the Gristlebrand. It's okay. I'll still do this. Grief. I know they have a bunch of spells in hand. All right, I'll take Karn. Ephemerate the Grief. Take Wurmcoil. And they have just Forest in hand. And then if they draw and they... If they draw a spell this turn, it's kind of nice. I get to steal it with Grief. Well, that's not true, because I think I'm actually going to Ephemerate the Phalagi Archaeologist. So I guess I won't know if they draw a spell. And then I still have Subtlety and Commandeer at the ready. O-Stone. Okay, I still don't care about that, because they can't use it yet. And I get to Ephemerate the Archaeologist now. See if I can not miss on this Archaeologist. I missed on the first one. It didn't hit lands off my Tainted Indulgence. It's really just classic bad beats. Okay, sure, I guess I'll get another Ephemerate. All right, I milled Atroxa and Gristlebrand. So I only have one Atroxa left. All right, there's a Marsh Flats, nice. Send and... Guess I'll just pass. I don't really need to play another Archaeologist. I like keeping blue cards for subtleties and whatnot. Now they're cracking the map. So did they find a Tron piece? Or are they just going to get an Urza Saga and go a different direction here? No, they... So I wonder if they found the Tron piece. I don't know. Let's get Undercity Sewers. Ooh, Surveil Faithful Mending into the graveyard, and then cast Faithful Mending, I think. And then discard. I don't want to discard the island. I guess I can discard an Ephemerate, a Phalagi Archaeologist. Oh, there's an Atroxa. All right, that Atroxa I do not want to pitch. Hit for three, and then I have Subtlety up as well. And I can always flashback Faithful Mending if I want, though I don't love the idea of that. Chromatic Sphere, okay. I mean, at some point I could Ephemerate the Grief, I guess. They are tapping their power plant. They draw another power plant. And they could O-Stone here. Otherwise, they're not going to have the mana to O-Stone. I should have actually gotten Black-White Land over Undercity Sewers. I just kind of got that one. To be honest, I didn't think about it all that much. And then I have Force Negation ready. I'm a little worried about getting Ulamogged here at some point. Oh, we are O-Stoning? I guess I don't even know what I'm hoping to have happen here. Exile my graveyard. Okay, do I want to cast Faithful Mending? I think so. I don't think there's a reason not to. And then they're going to... Oh, Stone in response, sure. That's a really weird way to sequence all this stuff, I guess. What they wanted to do was crack Crypt and then O-Stone, but... All right, I'm going to give it to them. I'm going to discard the Commandeer. And I think the swamp. The reason I'm discarding swamp is I want to draw a white source or hedge maze, which I didn't mill, right? Yeah, I did not. Okay, that's important. Very important. I don't think swamp helps me in my goals all that much. And I think Ephemerate could be pretty good here. Ephemerate Subtlety, like if they cast a Wyrmquil and I Subtlety it, and then later they cast a Karn or something and I Ephemerate it, that sounds pretty good. It's also like part of this whole Solitude thing, so I don't know. They have one card in hand. I feel like we're doing okay here. My plan is just cast Atroxa and play my spells until then. I've got some decent controlling spells here. All right, they passed. All right. What I don't want them to do is just draw Tron lands. What I do want is them to draw spells they can play, especially ones that let me Subtlety. Oh yeah, let's Subtlety this Karn, because I feel like there's like very little chance, because that's part of the reason I want to discard the Commandeer. I want them to start playing these things. Oh, what is this? Dismember. Oh. Huh. If I force this, they're at 8. They have no cards in hand. And this is my last Atroxa. I actually think I am going to force pitching the Atroxa. I'm pretty far away from Atroxing them. And let me just see. They put Karn on top. Yeah, all right. That I think means I can win fairly easily. So let's attack with Subtlety. They go to 5. And then I can go Tainted Indulgence. Draw. Discard the Grief. Play a Plains, pass the turn. They play Karn. I Ephemerate, attack them down to 2. And then if they put it on top, they just straight up lose. And if they don't, well, there's not that much that can get them out of Subtlety attacking plus end of turn Solitude. Wyrmquil doesn't do it. Non-creature spell doesn't do it. Most creatures don't do it. There's no like Eldrazi you can play on this much mana. You got to play the Karn. You put the Karn on top. Like, what were you expecting to have happen here? I mean, I'm sure they're just looking at their sideboard to decide, but yeah, no. Sorry, that is not going to do it. So now they have to put it on the bottom. I'm not even going to look. They have to put it on the bottom or they lose. And if they cast the Karn, then I win. Great. All right, well, I'm not going to cast Ephemerate here, obviously. Hallowed Fountain, I guess there's no reason to play it untapped. Attack, and ooh, a nice little 4-0. Very nice, very nice. Oh, and they hit Karn or Tron on the last turn, but that'll do it. A 4-0 start and finish here, because that is going to be our time for the day. And you know what? This deck's pretty good. There's a reason this deck's good, and it's got some pretty nice draws. Obviously, it's got every now and then it can be inconsistent, but just the whole Solitude Grief Ephemerate plan is already just its own thing, and then it has a cool reanimate plan as well. So I hope you enjoyed this video. As always, it was brought to you by Ultimate Guard, sponsor of Team CFB, and of course, TCG Player, the best place to get any Magic-related cards, accessories, strategy content. It's got it all. So head on over to tcgplayer.com, and you know what? I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.